Okay, so hi everyone, I welcome you all to my YouTube channel. So in this video, we will be discussing about the rate analysis. So before quoting, we have to do some rate analysis for different activities like earthwork and RCC, PCC, shuttering and so on. So this is one example of earthwork wherein we have to calculate that what are the rates and what is the total amount for accomplishing this particular activity, which is earthwork. Okay, so this is one excerpt from one BOQ. BOQ means bill of quantities. So in case of item rate contract, the client itself gives us this bill of quantities wherein all the quantities are mentioned, but you have to quote the rate, and after multiplying the rate with the quantity, you have to quote the amount, and this will give you the total amount for a certain activity, and the amount for all the activities will give you your contract value in case you win the contract. Okay, now see, in this case it is given that earthwork in soft soil depth is given as 0 to 1.5 meter. That means you have to excavate the earth, and first case is the depth of excavation is 0 to 1.5 meters. In second case, the depth is 1.5 to 3 meters. In third case, it will be 3 to 4.5 meters, and further on maybe 4.5 to 6 meters. The unit of measurement is meter cube, and the quantities are also given for the respective description item. So the total earthwork quantity that you have to execute as a contractor is 40,000 meter cubes. Now you have to give the rate for each of these items. So what we will do, we will not take the breakup, because hardly there will be any difference in the cost between these items, because there is very little change of depth. So what we will do, we will consider the complete volume of earthwork as 40,000 meter cube, and we will be calculating our cost for executing this 40,000 meter cube. Then on the pro rata basis, we will be dividing the rates amongst all these items. Also, what is given is the duration of work is given as 4 months, and the equipment that we are using is excavator, which has a capacity of 40 meter cube per hour, and we have dumpers. We don't know what is the number of dumpers, but we know the capacity of one dumper is 6 meter cube. What is excavator? Excavator is nothing which is used to excavate the earth. It has one bucket. Okay, so this will be excavating the earth, and it will be loading it into a dumper. So this is a dumper. Dumper is nothing but the trucks or the tippers that we say. So it has a capacity of 6 meter cube, and this excavator has a capacity of 50 meter cube per hour. So now I am rubbing the question. I am just noting down the important points that are given in this question. So we are given with the total volume of earth as 40,000 meter cube, and we are also given with the total duration of work as 4 months. From where we get the duration of work? We get it from the construction schedule that we prepare during the time of tendering. We prepare the schedule like earthwork will be from this month to this month, concreting, RCC will be from this month to this month. So this is the construction schedule from where we get the duration of the earthwork activity. Okay, and what else was given? Excavator has a capacity of 50 cubic meter per hour, and dumper has a capacity of 6 meter cube. Okay, we are also given the lead as 1 kilometer. So what is lead? See, this excavator will be excavating the earth from this point. Let's say this point is A. It will dumping or loading this earth into this dumper. Now, since this earth has to be dumped into this, so this dumper will take this earth and throw it away at a certain point. So this point is 1 kilometer away from the point where excavation is going on. So this is called as lead. And what is lift? Lift is the vertical distance that we have to measure, like 0 to 1.5 meter in the BOQ that was given, no? So that was called as the lift. Lift means we have to lift something vertically, but lead is we have to take a lead in the horizontal direction. So lead is for horizontal distance and lift is for vertical distance. So this is what we are given with all the data. So now you have to calculate the total cost. Now see, what is the total cost comprised of? Total cost is nothing but labor, material and your plant. So in this case, it is very much clear that the material will not cost anything, since what you are doing is you are just taking the earth and you are dumping it somewhere. You are not purchasing the material or anything. So material cost will be simply zero. but you will definitely have some labor cost and plant cost. In this case, as we are able to see that the excavation is being done with the help of an excavator and dumpers. Okay, dumpers are throwing it and coming back. So laborers will only be used to run this excavator and to run this dumpers and to clean this bucket. This bucket will get dirty after a certain point. Okay, after excess usage, this bucket will get dirty. So you will have to deploy a laborer who will clean this bucket also. So you will require labor. So labor cost will be simply the normal time, labor that will be used for the normal duration, and overtime. And what is the plant cost comprising of? It is equipment cost. That means you will either purchase the equipment or you will take it on hire. So equipment cost and its running cost, fuel and power cost. So definitely in this case we will be having the labor cost also, because we will be requiring the operators as well as the cleaners or helpers, and we will also be requiring the plant, which is very much given in the question, that we will be requiring the excavator as well as the dumper. Now excavator is simply one excavator, but what about the dumpers? We don't know the number of dumpers, we don't know the number of laborers, nothing we know. So everything we will be assuming in this case, but the number of dumpers we will be calculating, that how many dumpers we will require. Okay, so let's go to the first step, that is calculating the total number of dumpers. Okay, now see, you are given with the volume of earthwork as 40,000 meter cube. So this is the volume that you have to execute in time duration of 4 months. Okay, since this was very much given in the question. Now, what will be the excavation per month? So you can calculate by dividing 40,000 by 4. So this is giving you 10,000 meter cube of excavation per month. Now, what will be the excavation per day? Now, here you have to assume that for how many number of days a site is running. See, in civil engineering, you must be knowing that site goes on almost every day, but still we are taking some factor here. We are considering 4 Sundays as off days. Okay, so we are considering 4 Sundays as off days. So that means we are considering 26 number of days in a month. So 10,000 divided by 26. Okay, so if you will divide this, then you will get 385 meter cube after rounding off. Okay, now see, this is usually we are calculating that it will be 385, but sometimes it might be more also, sometimes it might be less also, but we have to account for the peak excavation. We cannot calculate the number of dumpers for 385. In case it will exceed to like 400 450, we will be running short of the dumpers. So we have to account for the peak excavation, because we never know that on what day we are able to exceed this excavation. Usually we will be doing under this only, like 300, 350, 385, but suppose if we go to 450, then in that case we will not have enough number of dumpers. So we have to always take some factor of safety, and we have to account for the peak excavation, and we have to take it almost 25%. Most of the cases the factor of safety in civil engineering is taken as 25% for the rate analysis I am talking. Okay, but for overtime charges and all, you have to consider it as 50%, but here it is considered as 25%. So we are multiplying 385 by 1.25. So we will get the peak excavation as 482. So let us say it as 500 meter cube. We are rounding it off simply because the number is almost equal to 500 meter cube. Okay, so now I am rubbing this part. Now see, let's talk about the excavator. See, this excavator is capable of doing 50 meter cube of the excavation in 1 hour. That means 1 meter cube can be done in 1 divided by 50 hours. So if we calculate this hours into minutes, then it will be 60 divided by 50. That means 1 meter cube of the earth excavator can excavate is in 1.2 minutes. So this is the time that the excavator will be take to dig 1 meter cube of the soil or the earth. So now, since the dumper that we have is having a capacity of Q2 as 6 meter cube, if you remember, then 6 meter cube of the earth will be dug in 6 into 1.2, that is 7.2 minutes. That means one excavator will be able to fill one dumper fully in 7.2 minutes. So this is nothing but the loading time. Okay, let us take it as equation 1. Now see, what will happen is this excavator will fill this dumper. Now this dumper will go and dump the earth at 1 kilometer lead distance. It will tip the earth there, it will rotate, and then it will cover the 1 kilometer distance back again. So basically, apart from the 7.2 meters, we have to travel this 1 kilometer 2 times. That means based on the speed of the dumper, we will calculate that time. Speed equals to distance upon time, so time equals to distance upon speed. We will also calculate the tipping time, how much time it will take to tip the earth at the place of dumping site. So that also we will assume, and along with it, it will rotate and it will have some other resistance also. So we will take some time for turnover and some movements also. Okay, so this is the loading time. Okay, now travel time. So travel time will be nothing but speed equals to distance upon time. So time equals to distance upon speed. So what is the distance? Distance is 2 km, not 1 km, because it has to go and it has to return back also at the place where excavation is going on. What is the speed? Let us consider that the dumper, see, dumpers cannot run as your bikes and all. The place where it has to dump will not be that even. So they have to restrict their speed to a certain limit. And they also have several restrictions at site that the dumpers cannot move beyond the speed of 15 kilometers per hour or 20 kilometers per hour, because what happens is the place is uneven and the dumpers is fully loaded. So in case it tips, then it will cause some troubles to the site, and there may be some accidents and incidents also. Okay, so for that case, on the safer side, we are keeping the speed as 15 kilometers per hour. So that means 2 divided by 15 hours is the time. So let us convert it into minutes. So 2 into 60 divided by 15. So it will be 8 minutes. So this is the travel time for the dumper. Okay. Now let us consider that the tipping time. Now this dumper has to go there and it has to tip also. So the tipping time, we are just assuming that it should not take like almost 1 minute, let us assume. So this will be our third equation. Okay, it should, see, it's taking 7.2 minutes just to fill. So hardly it will take 1 minute or even 30 seconds, 40 seconds. So to be on the safe side, we are assuming it as 1 minute. Now apart from this, I told you turnover time and some resistance or movement time, because it will not go like this, it has to turn also, and there will be some other resistance or some other movements also. So let us consider that time as 3 minutes. This is nothing, again an assumption. So the total time for one cycle, that means loading, dumping, traveling and coming back to the place where excavation is going on, will be equation 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. That means 7.2 minutes plus 8 minutes plus 1 minute and plus 3 minutes. So this is coming out to be 19.2 minutes. Okay, now see. Now 19.2 minutes will be taken by one dumper to return back after completing the one cycle. So now take one scenario. This is the excavator. At time t equals to 0, it will start the excavation and it will load this dumper. At t equals to 7.2 minutes, this dumper will be fully ready. It will be fully loaded with earth and it will go and it will dump there, and at t equals to 19.2 minutes only, it will be in a position to return back. Till that particular time, from 7.2 minute to 19.2 minute, this excavator will be idle. So what do? We deploy one more dumper that will come at 7.2 minutes. At t equals to 7.2 minutes, it will come, it will be empty. The excavator will fill the earth and at t equals to 14.4 minute, this excavator will also get full, this dumper will also get full. It will go and then again it will come back. To come back, it will take 7.2 plus 19.2 minutes. At 7.2 minute, it was completely empty. So at 7.2 minute, one cycle will take 19.2 minutes. So this dumper will return at t equals to 7.2 plus 19.2. That means 26.4 minute. Now, after 14.4 minute also, the first dumper would have not returned, because this dumper will only return at 19.2 minute. But this dumper, second dumper, it left at 14.4 minute. That means we will require one more dumper, and that third dumper will fulfill the complete requirements. I'm rubbing this and I'll just show you how. See, now at t equals to 14.4 minute, third dumper will come. Okay, this third dumper will be empty at this minute, completely empty. But at after 7.2 minutes, that means at 21.6 minute, this dumper will be fully loaded and it will go. But by 21.6 minute, the first dumper would have already returned, because the cycle time for first dumper is 19.2 minutes, which is less than 21.6 minutes. That means total number of dumpers that we require is 3. Instead of doing this complete complex calculation, there is one formula which we can use to calculate the number of dumpers. The formula is time to load plus time to haul. Haul means go, tip, move and come back. Again divided by time to load. So this is nothing but 7.2 time to load, and time to haul was nothing but 12. That means 8 plus 1 plus 3, and time to load is 7.2. So this is coming out to be 2.66. So we cannot have 2.6 dumpers, so it will be 3. We cannot have 2 because 2.66 is required minimum. So to overcome this, we will be taking as 3 dumpers. So instead of doing this complex thing, we can simply use this formula and calculate the total number of dumpers. Okay, so now we have the total number of dumpers. Total number of excavator is already 1, which we already know. Now we can assume something, assume the cost and all, and then we can calculate the owning cost. P&M means plant and machinery, which is nothing but your excavator and your dumper. P&M, owning cost. Okay, so we have one excavator and then we have dumper. So excavator is 1 and dumpers as per our calculation is 3. Now we have to calculate the higher charges per month. So we can simply assume this, but if it will be some objective kind of question, and then in that case they will have to give you the higher charges. So for excavator, the higher charges is somewhere around 1,25,000. For dumper, we can assume that one dumper we can hire in 50,000 rupees. Okay, so this is per month. So now we have to multiply this by the number of months. So from the calculation, from the initial given data, we know the number of months is 4. So what will be the total cost is nothing but multiply all this. So this will give you a cost of 5 lakh rupees and this will give you a cost of 6 lakh rupees. So total cost is coming out to be 11 lakh rupees. But this is not it. You have hired the equipment, but that does not mean that you will not have any other overhead cost for this. Simply you will have some operation and maintenance. You will have to keep some spares, you will have to do some maintenance. In that case it requires repair and all. In that case you will have to exceed this amount. So you cannot say that you will be owning the equipment completely in 11 lakh. You will have some other cost also, which is nothing but your O&M cost. So I told you we have to take it as 25%. So we can take 25% of 11 lakh, which is nothing but 2 lakh 75,000. Apart from this, see, this is the hire, but you have to mobilize also from a certain point. But from where you have to mobilize, you don't know. So you just assume some mobilization cost. Mobilization means to bring from a certain point to other point. For example, your equipment are in some factory or in some other site, in some other city. In that case, you will have mobilization for excavator also and for dumper also. For excavator, let us say it's 50,000. And for one dumper, let's say it's 20,000. So for three dumpers, it will be 60,000. So the total owning cost will be this, plus this, plus this, plus this. So it will be 14,85,000. So let us say that this is our equation A. Okay. So now we have to calculate the fuel and power cost. Now we know excavator and dumper. Excavator is 1, dumper is 3, the number of months is 4, number month. Then since we know the cost of liter, cost of fuel will be in per liter, so and cost of liter will be, fuel will be in liter per hour. Cost will be per liter. So we will convert it into days and hours. So again, days is 26. Let us consider it is running for 10 hours because usually the site runs for 10 hours, not for 8 hours. We always have some overtime. And the fuel cost, let's say, is 13 liter per hour. That means, sorry, not the fuel cost, the capacity. That means it requires 13 liters per hour to run. And this will require less since it is a dumper, so 5 liter per hour. Now what is the cost per liter? So let's say this is as 38. This is not the recent data, definitely we are just assuming some data. And again, I told you we require the operation and maintenance also, so oil and lubricant will be required, so we will take a factor of safety as 1.3, let's say. So the total amount, you can also take it as 1.25. So 6,67,888. You have to multiply all this. Similarly for this also, 7,70,640. So the total fuel cost will be 14,38,528. So this is B. Now we know the total cost of owning and the total cost of fuel and power. Now we can calculate the labor cost. See, I told you one will be the excavator operator, other will be the helper for bucket cleaning, and other will be the dumper driver. Okay, numbers. So definitely one excavator is there, so one operator will be required. Let us take two helpers and dumpers, since they are three numbers, so we require three dumpers, dumper drivers. Number of months is 4, 4, and 4. Then number of days, 26. Now wage per day. Why we are taking it in days, not in months? Because wages are usually given in per day. So let's say this is 220. This is 180. Since it's a helper, it will be unskilled and it will be lesser skilled than the excavator operator. So 200 rupees per day for dumper drivers. So the total amount you can calculate by multiplying all this. So 22880, then this is 37,440, and then this is 62,400. So the total is coming out to be 1,22,720. But we have to take some overtime also, because they will not be working for 8 hours. Instead, it will go to 10 hours or 12 hours also. So let us take it as 50%. I told you initially that overtime usually we take for 50%. So it will be 61,360. So this plus this equals 1,84,080 rupees. So this is equation C. So the total cost will be the sum of all the equations A, B and C. So total will come out to be 14,85,000 plus 14,38,000 528 and 1,84,080. So this is coming out to be 31,07,608 rupees. So this is corresponding to 40,000 meter cube of earth. So per meter cube cost will be this divided by this, which is nothing but rupees 78. So this is the cost of excavation, 78. Now you can divide this cost in the in those four subheads, 1.5 to 3 meters. You have been given the quantity for those items. You just take on the pro rata basis. Then for 40,000, the cost is this much. For this much quantity, the cost will be this much. And the rate will be this much. I hope this is clear to you. So this is the final answer that we were looking for. This is the main answer. You can divide it on pro rata basis. Doesn't matter much. So we'll be coming up many more videos related to concreting. Also we'll be covering related to the Delhi schedule of rates and state schedule of rates also. So stay tuned and subscribe to the channel.